have brought life to Professor Upsidasium's physiotronic audiographic steampunk archive, capturing images and sound from DragonCon 2012. In this transmission, time-traveling gentleman journalist Sean Peck.
Hello, sir. Can you tell me about yourself and all this great stuff here in front of you?
My name is Sean Peck. I go by the name Peck Tech, and I'm a steampunk journalist.
Steampunk journalist?
I'm the time-traveling gentleman journalist. And if you'd like to see my stuff, let me start you down here.
Please.
One of my best things that I've built is this steampunk guitar. And this was actually a regular pawn shop guitar. It was around $35. And I've altered it in nearly every way possible just to make it interesting and more of a work of art.
That is great. That is great. What can you tell us about this? What have you done here?
Well, what I did, this is an old Christmas ornament. It's got, actually has an LED earring in there. And this detaches, so you can play this on your knee if you want. And then it just goes, usually goes smoothly back on. This also comes off in case you want to change the strings.
Okay.
And it's just magnetized on there, rare earth magnets. This is a flickering LED from Christmas lights. And the whole thing unscrews, so you can change the batteries, turn it off and on. And that sort of thing.
Okay, that's a great guitar.
Moving on over here, I have my steampunk Steadicam. It is actually a functioning Steadicam.
Did you say anything?
Not perfectly balanced right now, but it's close. I can hold it in many different positions. Even up on the shoulder if I need to. Get tired.
We may have to consult with you on this later.
You can buy all these lamp parts at lampparts.com.
Okay.
Or if you're like me, you find one in the yard sale for $10.
We do all love our yard sales.
This was my very first steampunk accoutrement. We were coming to Dragon Con and we needed a costume, but we're kind of a portly group and we didn't want to be chubby superheroes, so steampunk seemed like a good fit. Plus, I've always been really artistic. I like to build things, you know, I like sculpture. So this is made out of just various different things. I took a plasma disc and I added a acrylic bowl. And you can see that it actually makes the plasma look three-dimensional. Most of the other parts are just clock parts and that sort of thing.
Okay.
And lastly, I attached belts on to use as straps. These
are just simple assembly there.
Yeah, this is very simply screwed in.
Okay.
As you see later on, I got a little bit more sophisticated and added pads for comfort. Comfort's important too.
So we're seeing a learning curve here directly from the first attempt.
Ouch.
Where we have some
less ouch.
Some taping versus some padding there. That's great. That's great. Now, these are found brass parts?
Yes. All of these are found brass parts, stuff from Goodwill and that sort of thing.
Okay.
This is the Junior Jetpack. They also have plasma discs with little things you buy at Radio Shack to help you read.
Okay.
Sort of soup up the light. And the brass parts are from one of those rental places where you go to rent instruments. I asked him if he had any instruments that have been banged up a little bit, and he said, yes, hundreds.
That is a resource I have not heard before.
Yeah.
So you're going to an instrument rental place.
Find your local middle school. Find out where they rent their instruments from and ask them if you can either buy or take. These were given to me. All these instruments were free. As you can see, they're very beat up. But in the steampunk world, that just means
we love
the test flight didn't go well.
Right. Adding character.
I found that if you take a good brass lamp, you can make it into about 100 different things. It's like the build your own lightsaber kit that you get for Star Wars.
Yes.
You can make all the different... A really big brass chandelier works the exact same way.
Okay. And what do we have there? Which is this?
This is a ray gun.
Alrighty.
What it does specifically, I don't know. I just thought it was...
That's a great shape.
An interesting build.
Marrying the brass and the wood there.
And what's cool is later on...
In a 70s oak and brass way.
Yes, and later on I plan to add lights inside of here.
Okay, so this one, this is more of a work in progress.
It is, it is.
Okay.
And this is an AK-47 stock, and I just kind of drilled into it.
All right. Now, what gave you the idea of looking for musical instruments to add to your build?
Well, the resources for brass are just kind of limited, and you know, I didn't want everything to be a lamp part.
Right.
You know, that's kind of what I was working with, because I can screw them together, take them apart, and I don't have to glue them necessarily. I can bolt them together so they don't just fall apart. So, it's like, what else is made of brass? Mm-hmm. And my daughter plays the French horn in her band. So while we're at the rental place, I noticed that they had this bucket with some broken brass pieces in it, and I thought, oh, I could use some of those tubes. And then they ended up giving me a part of a trombone and three trumpets. Added a few copper pieces to kind of take them away from what they would normally look like.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what I came up with.
You've come up with some great ideas. And I noticed your bird theme here. Was this deliberate or...?
Yes, I really wanted something interesting to put over the top of it. And I found a larger set for this side, but this backpack is getting too heavy already. And my wife generally carries it around. So just to be nice, I didn't add that onto there.
Right.
But yes, just another yard sale find, $2 pair of birds.
Okay. Now, show me... this device here, you were indicating this is a camera pack?
Yes, what this does, I like to do interviews, much like we're doing now, but I don't always have a camera person with me.
Right, I know that curse very well.
So what I can do is I can unsnap this, let me get it out a little bit, and it will swing around all the way out in front of me. And with the wide-angle lens, I can do interviews and be in the interview. Or, what I like to do, like for the parade this morning, what I did is I turned the camera around, and I can use my hand to kind of steady it a little bit, and I can shoot whatever I'm looking at as I walk around. It's got a very wide-angle lens, so although there's no, the GoPro doesn't have, there's an LCD back you can put on it, but I don't have it. Although you can do that, it's so wide-angle, pretty much what you see, it sees, so it's great to just guess.
Okay. Now, your power requirements on a camera like this, how are you handling that? Is there a battery pack inside?
There's a battery inside. It lasts about 2 hours.
Okay.
You know, that's 2 hours straight.
Right.
If that's all you do.
Mm-hmm.
But I have not run out yet. I bought an extra battery for $20 online.
Mm-hmm.
Have not run out of battery yet.
That is a great system, and I may have to talk to you about that in the future.
The only thing for this is you need separate sound, because all the creaking and cranking, it picks up every bit of it. So I actually made this holster, and inside, I've got my sound recorder.
Oh. And I'm still looking at the holster there, okay.
And what goes with the sound recorder is this microphone. What I did here, this is a lamp part. It doesn't look like much now with all the cord wrapped around, and an old flash. And I took a lapel mic and I stuck it in there. This will plug in the bottom,
right?
Like so. And I've got a microphone to do interviews.
You, sir, are a much brighter man than I.
Oh,
I must congratulate you on that.
Take
piece
this
of
stuff and go with it, you know?
Okay. I wanted to ask you about the clock pieces on the front of the camera case, too.
Oh, okay.
I want to show this.
Oh. This is a clock I found at I don't know if it's Goodwill or some other thrift store.
Mm-hmm.
And I disassembled it, and it actually met with a terrible fate yesterday.
Oh.
As this whole contraption fell off my bed. But let's see if I can... I have a pendulum set up. It's not going to work for me.
No, it looks like you're... it looks gorgeous.
There we go.
All right.
So
when
it's working properly, the pendulum turns back and forth, and this will move as you move.
Okay.
But it's come unglued.
Right.
So now I have to use my fingers.
Be very careful and cautious with your brass, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right.
Good. Well, anything else? Oh, what are these pieces here? You have some goggles up front, and
Oh, and that is my business card holder.
Your business card holder.
Yes. So if you'd like to check me out on YouTube, that's me.
And I suggest that everybody does check out Mr. Peck Tech on YouTube. Well, sir, it has been a pleasure meeting you, and thank you very much for your time.
I'm a big fan, Professor of Silesian.
Thank you. Take care.
See ya.
You have been watching Professor Upsidasium's Visuotronic Audiographic Steampunk Archive. For more information about DragonCon, go to www.dragoncon.org. Special thanks to the Alternate History Fan Track. For more information, go to alternatehistory.dragoncon.org. Very special thanks to our guest, Sean Peck. Please view his videos at www.youtube.com/user/pecktech. Our theme music, The Visuotronic Blues, was written and performed by Alex White at TheGearHeart.com. Our motion graphics were created by John Adams of Blithwolf Studios, found at blithwolf@gmail.com. Please stay tuned as the experiment continues.